for the championship final round in the Super Modified Unlimited Mud Racing Division here at the U.S. Harvard Association Super Bowl of Motorsports. Here's the Chevy Underglass Chief Funny Car of Terry Marshank from Largo, Florida, utilizing again a Chevrolet small block power plant. We've got a lot of guys here tonight utilizing the small block underdog motors. He'll be up against this piece of equipment, the Shadow 1927 Ford Roadster, being driven by Gene Sparks from Cocoa, Florida. This machine, another 468 cubic inch big block Chevy, fuel injected and using nitrous oxide injection. So the Shadow with the big block power plant, yellow Chevrolet Underglass Chief Funny Car, using a 378 cubic inch small block fuel injection and, of course, that extra oxygen from nitrous oxide injection.
These are like two of the lightest cars I've seen this season.
As a matter of fact, neither one weighs more than 2,300 pounds. But as we pointed out on past U.S. Harvard Association National Event telecast, most of these drivers are opting now for machines as light as 2,000 pounds in unlimited mud racing here in the Super Modified Division. The Shadow clears out the big block power plant and now moves into stage. But the hole shot by a bunch goes to the small block. Unfortunately, Terry Marshang had to get out of the throttle as it looked like he was almost going to go out of bounds. A tough break as Marshang had a great run running. He was forced to lift off the throttle at about the 80-foot marker when the machine started going sideways and heading for the left side boundary. And Marshang gets an lap time of 2.70 seconds sideways, but in the other lane, Gene Sparks in the Shadow had the worst tire spin we've seen so far. Never got any kind of momentum, and poor Sparks is in there trying to figure out what in the world he's going to do. The steam off the exhaust headers as he finally comes across the finish line at 4.28 seconds. Here's Billy Boydston in the GD Calls True Grid, another machine utilizing big block Chevrolet Motivation, this time with carburetors and nitrous oxide injection. And he'll be taking on a machine that did exceptionally well here last year, the Magnum Force Jeep of Mike and Richard Jones from Titusville, Florida. The 22-year-old has been involved in some kind of racing, Shelley, for 10 years behind the wheel of this machine.
Well, both of them sound like the movie fans, too. True Grit versus Magnum Force, like John Wayne versus Clint Eastwood here.
It should be a heck of a battle, no question about it. If I had to put favoritism on any machine, it would be the machine that you see on the left-hand side of your screen, the Magnum Force number 2 of Mike and Richard Jones. A car that can easily put down a low two-second blast. Dickie Wilson still leading the standings in that lane at 2.28 seconds, even though no less than five drivers have come within 15 hundredths of a second of that time.
Well, I know if Magnum Force wins, it will make his day.
A classic shot of the rear view of these machines. 5 foot 6 inches wide at the back. The DOT cut thread tires, and the whole shot goes to the Jones brothers. No contest. Even though the incredible True Grit stock wheelbase machine of Bill Boydston gave him a run for it all the way down, Boydston started getting sideways near the finish line, and the Magnum Force boys will get the win in this round.
You know, both these drivers had to do some serious driving. Here you see Jones. He is definitely working on that steering wheel as he comes across the finish line on a slippery path. 2.74 seconds, looking over to see if he even got to the finish line first on that one. But tire spin is becoming a problem as we get into the later run. Watch the stock wheelbase Jeep, the True Grit. This was some driving to keep this thing straight in the lane and still under power. He goes through it a losing 2.96 seconds, but that stock wheelbase gave him a ride.
This is the walking tall Jeep of Buddy Abbott from Winter Haven, Florida. The right-hand side of your screen, the driver who won the New Orleans Superdome Championship last year, Rod Perry and John Willis's Whiplash, 468 cubic inch Chevrolet power machine. Shelley, he'll be taking on the blue entry at the top of the screen of Buddy Abbott from Winter Haven, Florida, called Walkin' Tall, using 514 cubic inches of Ford. There's the Ford machine. They leave the starting line, and an unbelievable upset as Perry bogged the motor about 30 feet off the starting line. And the blue Ford-powered machine of Buddy Abbott came back for the win. Rod Perry in the Whiplash Jeep, an upset loss in this first round of competition. And Buddy Abbott taking his Ford-powered Jeep Funny Car to a well-deserved victory. But I'll tell you, despite the stunned look on Abbott's face, Shelley, it is not often you see Rod Perry lose.
The man who won the New Orleans Championship 1.5 years ago leaves the starting line and bogs badly. You can see him get back in the throttle, the tire speed evident by the incredible distortion. But the lap time, 2.70 seconds, is a lot slower than Rod Perry will normally put down. In the other lane, Bud Abbott, the walking tall machine, got sideways down near the finish line. He stays in the throttle of the machine perfectly at an angle, then straightens out when he gets out of the throttle at 2.57.
So the final round will pit the Black Magic Corvette of Al Stebbins, the killer for the last 5 years in this part of the country, against Dickie Wilson's A-Team Jeep Buddy Car in the championship super modified dash for all the marbles. And we'll be back with more action at the U.S. Automobile Association Super Bowl of Motorsports in just a moment.